Hey guys, and welcome back to Bubble Burst. Today I'm going to be doing an IV class. So today I'm going to show you how to mix from a prepackaged vial into the IV bag. So let's get started. So you see that we have our IV bag. We'll need to prime this. To raise my IV pole. Now, when you raise your IV pole, obviously this has the tubing and everything already for us, because our previous ER nurse is awesome. You guys, her test is awesome, so we've got that. It's a gift she gives us, is having our IV poles ready. Okay. Now, what if you were going to hang two bags of . So I'll show you the procedure two times. That's basically what I'm trying to feed in here. Okay, so this one's all primed and ready for us. It says normal saline, one liter. And I have one more that I'm gonna hang up for you guys. It's an audio vlog, sadly, so I can't show you anything I'm on my brown note today. So do excuse that there are no pictures. So, I have another bag of NS here, normal saline. So, this is a 1 liter bag as well. Now, you're asking me, why are you hanging both bags? And the reason I hang both bags is to ensure that we can give 2 liters, because that's what the patient has a fluid goal of. So, we'll slip it on like so. We want the label facing us. And now this one you would spike and da 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 da. This is actually going to be a secondary. So we don't need a big long tubing spike. So if I can find it, we'll be using the secondary set with extension set. Anyway, it connects to the patient. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys are experiencing, I'm sure all of you are experiencing supply chain issues. And this, you guys, cannot find the tubing set I want. This is a disastrous mess. No, that's not it. Sorry, you guys. Other nurses that can help you. Ah! She's amazing! She found it! Okay. So this is the secondary set. Let me get it all sterile, because I know you guys are going to judge me. Actually, so we have our tubing set here. This kinks up a lot. I'm just gonna set it where I want for now. Generally I prefer my clamp like halfway up. So we'll close it right here. The air door is going to stay drip height because, we would want a good drip height. Now, our primary set has a spot for the vial to connect. And this is actually really helpful if you were going to run it. So I'll show you all the different ways you can run this medicine because I do believe that it is important. Now, this tubing that I have has a spot to insert the needle, which we're keeping sterile here. It's also an air filter. And then there's a connection area that I have capped with a alcohol cap. Now, the bottom of this has a spot that you would connect to an IV if you were going to give this. And we are going to, in fact, be giving this to a different patient. Okay, so first I'll show you the tubing way since I have this. So you're gonna open this up and you're gonna remove your needle. The reason I had everyone if you jumped on live, the reason I had everyone grab a catheter is because the top of it allows you to use this nice safety mechanism. You just put in there, and boom, no more sticks, you're protected. And just the top pokes out, or an IV. Okay, so you're going to, first, you can keep this on there too if you want, to keep it sterile for now. So the first thing I'm going to do is get a flush, because I want to flush that port pretty well. With some normal saline. So I'm going to grab some normal saline for my notes. I wasn't planning on vlogging today either, you guys. But I will film an update if I have time to make full videos because I have another sleepover. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is get my normal saline flush. And I'm going to take it, and I'm going to attach. Well, I'm going to swab for 15 seconds, and then I'm going to attach. I have a green cap. I'll need to get a new one of those. I'm just going to, whoopsies, I'm just going to attach in a clockwise motion. Okay, so now that this is attached, you guys, actually going to flush the whole thing in using a push-pause method. Sorry, I'm trying to get a recap because when we're done, we're going to recap this and keep everything clean for now because I'm teaching. I'm getting it all set up. And we're going to do half of this is going to be a secondary infusion, but this is just, need to administer anything, you would administer through your main line, and so that's what I'm teaching you, I guess, is, and I want to keep this main line nice and clear and patent for us. Now, you can pull back or you cannot pull back, it's up to you. During the priming process, though, it's crucial that you open, like, every single roller clamp just until you see the drops come to the top. So I pulled back on the syringe. I'm going to, no, cooperate with me. Silly tubing. I'm going to raise this a bit more because my infusions are being fresh. There we go. I like it at that height. It's a little bit easier for me to reach. Okay, there we go. Now I'm not hunching as much. I'm going to open my clamp, pull it where I want it, and open it. And we'll do one at a time. It's safer to prime this way. Alright. So, obviously, we're going to prime until we see drops come to the bottom. But this is unclamped. So, when you pull back, you're going to get saline in your syringe. It's the same saline that you're going to give to the patient, because you have to run a carrier with the medication I'm giving. So you're going to want to pull back and, like, you can put the saline back, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So I'm almost at the cap. I'm going to take the cap off because it's kind of pointless to prime this if you don't have the cap on. Over the trash. Lastly, I'm going to push the saline in. And the mainline medicine administration will come later. I just want to show you how to get that ready. We'll clamp this again. Thank you for letting me know. I'm just recapping my tubing because that's kind of key. You need to. I'm the wrong patient, so I'm getting the right patient. Because that's the thing, you guys, is when you perform your checks, you want to get the right patient. And we take care of three different patients. Each nurse takes care of three different patients. So I'm putting, the patient just came in. Just a second, okay, sweetie, I'm just getting everything set up. So explain to your patient that they need to back up so you can set everything up. Alright. And you can actually leave your tubing right there and put your syringe in the discard pile. Sorry guys, this is going to be a long video. It's 12 minutes and 52 seconds. It's probably going to be about maybe 20, well, maybe a little bit longer than 20 minutes. So, I know one video I made was almost an hour. I'm so sorry for that, you guys. I just needed to sit down, vlog, and get some crap out of my head. But let's get back to this video. So, I'm going to prime my secondary tubing, and you can actually back prime, and what back prime means is you're going to take, untwist, I'm just going to leave it loosely so that I can grab the other one. I hope it doesn't pull on anything. Now this tubing is so short, I think this is meant to be IV pump tubing, but it's not. You're probably just not used to it with the primary tubing that you use. So we're going to clamp this off. You need an extension set for this. Unfortunately, you can't just... let me grab the extension set. You need an extension tubing for this. You can't just warlock it, and I wish it was possible. It's not humanly possible. Well, guess what? You shut up and you make the most of it. Oops, there's a little knot there. Okay, whatever. We're gonna be fine. Some people who like need this for short-term use, well, like if you're just using an IV and you want to extend it, would take their IV. Alright, so we're leaving this piece sterile, because this is what we're gonna, this is our main line up here. Sorry, I'm using main line, but that's a very bad term. Let me get an injection needle, because you're gonna inject it into a special spot in the tubing. And holy cow, you guys, I did not prime that site. So, okay. We'll be fine. So I'm taking my site. And it's easier to inject this with a syringe and take the tubing and connect it. I'm hoping it's going to go in just as flush as it normally would. And you're going to keep this clamp is going to be open as well as the other one. You want all your clamps open in order to run this. And I believe the vial will hook up to that IV bag. Or you can run it normally and just hook the vial up there. So there's two different ways to do it. I'm sorry, you guys. This is really bad explaining. I'm like trying my best. As peaceful as possible. I'm so scared to put this in. Tell me I'm being a baby. God. Oh my God, you big baby. You can't even insert that. Give me it. All right, you guys. Princess is being rude. This is all you hear. Ouch. There we go. I got it. Hurts though to get it off, doesn't it? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Medicine is pain sometimes. So normally I will draw up a sterile water injection. Whoops. So you guys can take your normal saline, your sterile water, whatever you. Whatever you're planning to use, and you're going to administer this, and you want to do it before you prime anything. Make sure your mainline port is like nice and tight and secure, because like you know the cap, because you don't want any stuff that's not supposed to get in there. It's like when you insert it, it's tough because I'm trying to do it upside down because that's how the I think it's the needle you have. You guys, this needle is being really difficult with us. It's not staying in. Anyways, I have to prime the port anyways, so that's okay. Alright. So priming to this port looks a bit different, you guys. Because this is going to hang down out of the way. I'm going to put it on the bed so that it won't get contaminated. But you'll notice I'm pulling on my tubing a bit. You're going to, you may hear some people yell at you because you're pulling on your tubing. Like if you're setting this up in a critical situation, you have a lot of nurses around, you're going to get yelled at that you're pulling on your tubing and not to pull on it. So I usually put this back like this, and then what I do, this is just me, I take my normal saline syringe, push a couple mils, and I wait a few minutes just to make sure. Goodness, this IV line is being so difficult with me today. Hey Google, play music.
Music on YouTube Music.
Sorry, you
here
guys.
You go.
You're gonna hear my Google Home because that's what I'm listening to music on. Hey Google, play music.
Okay, music on YouTube Music. Here you go.
Hey Google, play music.
Playing some music on YouTube Music.
Hey Google, play Want You Back by Cher Lloyd.
Okay, Want You Back by Cher Lloyd, playing on YouTube Music.
Hey Google, volume down. I'm trying to be as like detailed as I can. Ow, I'm gonna hurt my finger doing this. The needles will get stuck on there sometimes. This is my music I'm playing in the background. Cher Lloyd is a great band. She got me like this. take it for a vial injection. Correct me if I'm wrong. For a vial injection. Here, use that one. It's on the bottom. Okay, for a vial injection, you're going to push the amount of medicine to the amount of flush to the amount of medication you have, and then you're going to use about a millimeter of saline to prime. I'm trying to use my no-touch technique because you need to be aseptic here. Meaning that you don't touch anything. Sorry, guys. The lighting is starting to get bad. And so now you're going to come over to the IV pole. Say your normal saline drip is running. You're going to click pause. Sorry. I raised the bags since we've been over here. I'm going to turn my air door. This is annoying. I don't know why this has an air bore on it, it just does. So you're going to take your needle that you have, and you're going to... Okay, and you can either pull it out or leave it in there. I'd say leave it in there, especially if you have, right, and you're going to pull it back until you see about a mil of solution. Enter the tubing. Okay, we've got our mill. This just wasn't inserted all the way. There we go. The needle's tiny. It's a little baby needle compared to the vial. Sorry, I was just given a different extension set. You guys, this day I feel like is going to turn me wrong. Okay. I don't know how to do anything. Here. Nope. Alright, so you're gonna put that there. Okay. Alright, and then you're going to take. You can take the end of the tubing and seat it in there. Meaning, you're going to literally take off the end of this and seat it end to the end of the. So instead of it being this long, it'll extend your length. So now your tubing is this long. It's so it doesn't drag when you do your second, like when you hang up, when you, oh my god, when you connect your secondary to the primary, to back. I'm going to show you next. Wow, you're doing good at this class today. Yes. You guys, I'm not sure how long this video will end up being, but if you need to fast forward the video or leave the video at any time, feel free to do so. Okay. So, we now have everything we've discarded, and this is how the vials come. In their packaging, they give you the little catheter in case you have the pump that allows you to use the catheter. And you should set the vial up prior to disconnecting the needle, putting it in the bag. So, I have my vial of, Zofran here. It's dosed out at the correct dosing for me. It would be ondansetron is the correct, like the generic name, I guess, of the medication. People say like drug in their video to like give you the idea. It's not. It's a medication, so we know. And they reference it. They mean that. So at the top here is supposed to be a plunger. However, there is not a plunger in the top. Therefore, it makes it nice and easy for you is with these nausea wipes today. But I will set this up for you before I do it. But you can see here that I've got extension set tubing that leads all the way from the pole to here. And if I open this, you'll see some saline start to drip out of this. Or actually it won't. Into the infusion, you can use some air and try and pull that medicine out. Now, the higher you hang your IV pole, the higher and the less amount that your extension set tubing will hang low. And the reason I encourage you to use a extension set to use this tubing is so that you don't get the pulling and the that you're in the wrong spot, and you can just hook it to wherever you want to hook it. In my case, I'm going to be hooking it to the primary. Okay, so let's do an example. So we're going to say that the primary is going to be running already. Because I'm all over the place today, and I'm so sorry. Let's see. Here's her IV. On both for the moment, but you'll see that the primary is running in her IV already. And she's got just normal saline up there. Okay, so this is open now too to allow the saline to come through to this tubing. Yeah, it does hang on the floor, you guys, so when you get that, tubing connected in your port, no. If it's the lower port, no, I encourage you to use your higher port. And then give all medication injections through the lower port because your tubing is less likely to hang on the floor. Okay. So we're going to add this. So I scan the patient's wristband. I've done all that jazz. Now I'm taking my extension set. This is this IV is directly for this medication. So if another thing were needed to be hung, another tubing set would have to be added, or another IV, because this IV is specifically for this medication. And she's specifically accessed to this medication. So I'm going to close this off. I don't know why it's open. It is. I'm going to close it off. Alright, so say. Alright. And at the end, I will not play the famous, like, the inspiring song just because I don't have a lot of time today. Alright. So, where was I? Right. Sometimes the vile is going to come with a cat boy for this, you guys. And consider yourself blessed if it does, because that is a headlock. That if for some godforsaken reason you need to leave the room, and all vials should be headlocked. Because God forbid you need to leave for a second, you know, and it hangs off the top of the catheter, so I know it looks a little funny, but if you need, like, it packages like this for a reason. If you need to leave the room, you know that your vial is going to be safe, because no one will be able to grab and administer this. Now, in our case, we need to administer and set it up, so I'm going to take the hub lock off. I just wanted to show you guys that our needles are coming with safety features. I'm going to hang this, I'm going to twist this on. This is a disgusting mess. Here we go. Alright, so we need a bill of normal saline to activate our medication. And the bill is just what they recommend. Use just a mill, and then we're going to fit it into our vial here. And the reason that you only need a mill is this vial is so small, you guys. It's not even funny. It's really small. Okay. So now, say we're ready to hook it up. Take your vial, and I hope you would cleanse your port that you're hooking up to. Ouch, I just banged my shoulder. And so, you're going to open this, and you're going to say run. Now, your pump will verify that everything is correct for you. If you have the Alaris, at least it will. I don't know for any other pumps. But all I know is this is connected safely, and it's connected because I forgot to do this. Yes, if you need to use the extension set, you need to unclip the extension set, or the medication won't be able to go through to the patient. Okay, so the primary is running well. It's been a bit. Now we're about to disconnect. And this is the last part of the video. I'm going to show you because I don't want to keep this video too long. I've already been vlogging for half an hour and 5 minutes. So, to disconnect, the first thing you're going to do is clamp all ports. It does not matter what ports they are. Take them, clamp them. It's a safety feature that at least our policy is a lot, like, makes us do. So you're going to clamp all ports. Even your normal saline, because you don't want to accidentally bolus the patient with more. Okay, so that's done. Alright, so next, we're going to slowly, one by one, disconnect everything. off the extension, like off your IV permanently, which my patient is. I just needed the IV for this time because it was her treatment for today. You're going to tap this, and you can, like, obviously you're going to complete all your documentation and stuff. And then you're going to, oops, I can put this back correctly. And you're going to want to dispose of all your material. So whatever you use, take it and dispose. So that means the spikes and everything, yep, you have to recap it. I'm in the wrong bin. That would help. Okay. Then we're going to get a tubing cap. The tubing that comes off the patient is the first thing to cap. But if you're near the end and you notice your patient is experiencing side effects, please, please, please keep your IV in and give a straight liter of normal saline. You do not want to administer a full medication, have the patient have side effects, and then you realize, oh, my patient has side effects after you've already disconnected them. Because once you disconnect them, it's too late. You can't go back. My patient is now disconnected. She doesn't feel any side effects, so she's going to go home after we're all done with this, and it just connects like that. Her IV is experiencing a little bleeding, but someone is already over there helping me with. Then you're just going to re-access your patient. And you're going to make sure that you have a cap. If I can find where I put the cap, I have no idea where the cap is. Oh, yay. I found the cap for that one. Okay. So, now you have all of your caps. So what you're going to do is you basically are, like, dismissing your patient, excusing them from therapy. Like, you're the one who's saying, okay, this patient is, like, I deem them good to go. So that's all set, that one. And then once everything's disconnected, you can raise your pole back down to normal and take the extra bag off. And if you need this in the next how many ever hours you use it, I would just put a red cap on. Sorry guys, I'm probably gonna sneeze. I say probably like I'm not. Okay. And then you need to cap your tubing correctly. So please listen as I give you instructions for this. You're going to take your spike cap like this. You can hold it by the drip chamber. And you're going to hold it down. And you're just going to hold on, you guys. This one's not fitting.
like it's 19. First up tomorrow, you have swim at 8 a.m.
Okay. So you have this, and I'm just putting that like that, and then... this forward, and then while you're doing the cleanup, hopefully someone else can dismiss the patient, because the cleanup takes the longest amount of time. Hi, sweetie, I hope you have a good day. I'm sorry, that's just my other nurse dismissing the patient when she's ready. So I am just trying to clean everything up. I'm going to discard all of this, you guys, and you would discard them in the proper disposals, not just blow them away. That's not going to cut it. Alright, I just have one more task. And that is, pour the hole back down all the way and put the tubing and loop it around the way I found it. It's pretty easy. I love and appreciate our sharpener. She puts all, whoops, if she starts an IV, she puts all she has the label, she has the tubing looped for us. She's amazing. But bye for now, you guys.